wasting the time. The kids were all here at 20 to 9. So don't be surprised if you hear them shout. Hey, the trousers is all inside out. Go, go, dick and doll. Go, go, dick and doll. Go, go, dick and doll. Go, go, dick and doll.
Come back.
And now, before you can say this,
Arsenal.
To you, let's make the bungalow heads.
We are back.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, and welcome to the bungalow.
Welcome to the bungalow.
At least first, come on in. Hello, mate.
Hello.
Hang on, can you send it back out again?
Doesn't look very happy to be here, does he?
A little bit more enigmatic, please, as if you just come on to an award-winning show.
Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen.
And let's meet the first bungalow head.
Award-winning show!
It's Enigmatic Elliot!
There we are, Enigmatic Elliot, how are you?
Fine.
Welcome to the bungalow! No, 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 everyone's woken up. See, why don't you go over there, stick your big fat face in the camera and wobble your cheeks. Ready?
Here he is.
Oh, there he is, there he is.
Elliot, how old are you, sir?
Nine. 98.
What you got a photo of here?
What's
it a photo of?
I dressed up as a grandma.
You dressed up as a grandma? And why did you... Do you always carry that around with you?
No.
Why did you dress up as a grandma?
Because it was funny.
It was funny. It's very funny indeed. Do you know what? He likes collecting bits and pieces.
Oh, look, what bits and pieces do you collect?
Stones.
Lovely.
Turn around, face everyone.
There they are.
Look what it says here. He can speak his own language. It's called chicken bar.
What's chicken bar, Elliot?
Speak chicken bar.
It's a language.
Well, say a bit of it to us. Don't understand a word of that, Elliot. So,
what are we going to do?
We have, hello over there, we have a translator in the bungalow who's going to translate the chicken bar for us. So, you say something to him, then he'll translate it back into English. We'll understand what you're saying.
Ah, yes, no, he's very happy to be here with you two wingnuts.
Wingnuts?
Yes.
Speak more to him.
Yes, well, he said only on a Tuesday, but it's very nice with fish.
Oh, could you tell him he's talking absolute nincompoople jibber jabber?
I say, oh, lad, you want to see him? A chickabarba? Chickabarba. Chickabarba? Oh, yes, yes.
Yes, all right.
Well, thank you very much.
Yes.
It's already alright, then.
She's happy to be here.
Ladies and gentlemen, watch this one. I think she's going to be our resident nutcase for the weekend. Look at her.
Come on. You just lobbed your bag on the floor.
It's not very nice. You can't go around lobbing bags.
What's your name and how old are you?
I'm Matilda and I'm 8.
Her name
she's
is Matilda.
Matilda and she's 8 and she's got a love. What is this?
They're for you.
They're for us.
And they're for you.
Oh, what are they? What do we do with them? Is it
they're
the
socks.
They're socks.
I might just try it as a scarf. There we are. Lovely.
Scarf.
Very long socks.
Very long.
You want to be a vet?
Yes.
Oh, lovely.
A vet.
And the silliest thing that you've ever done is gone in the bath with your wellies on.
Yes.
Why did you do that?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Maybe I like my willies too much.
Maybe you do.
Maybe you do. Apparently, maybe you like your bath.
Apparently, you're not afraid of anything, Matilda.
No.
No.
Well, follow me over here. You've got to go through. We're going to put it to the test now, Matilda, just to make sure that you are not scared of anything in this whole wide world. Come through here, come through here. And you're going to open that door, go in there, and see what happens. You ready?
Yeah.
Here you go. Matilda.
Yeah?
Was it scary?
No, piece of cake.
Piece of cake? Don't mind if I do. Lovely, love.
Give me some cake.
You want some cake as well?
Yes.
Yeah. Welcome to the bungalow. What a gag. What a gag.
Let's go sit down and have yourself to a nice cake.
A lovely gag to get us going on a Saturday morning.
Who's next? Yay! Yay! All right there, mate. Let's have your bag and listen. Ooh.
it bounced.
There you go. How are you? What's your name?
Bradley.
Brad. It's Bradley, everybody. Bradley. Take your coat, make yourself at home, warm yourself by the fire.
Do you like to be called Bradley or Brad, as it says on your badge?
Or Brady.
Or Brady.
All right, it says here that you like to sing and to dance. Do you?
Yeah.
Sing and dance. That's marvellous. All right, it says here you're very fussy about food and only eat chips, balls, roast potatoes, waffles, noodles, savoury rice, toasted white bread, crumpets, crisp ice cream, yogurt, jelly, custard, chocolate cake, biscuits, strawberry milkshake, fresh orange, diluted cordials, milk, some breakfast cereal. And you don't eat any meat, eggs, cheese, nor vegetarian substitutes or nuts.
We've got a top chef with us this morning who is Melvin, and here he is with a fantastic new drink for you.
It's nutritious.
Could you tell us what's in there, what nutrition you've put in there for me this morning?
I've put all the things he likes in it.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, I chopped the chips up myself. I put some ice cream in there, especially for you.
So, basically, in there, you've got chips, boiled and roast potatoes, waffles and all that stuff. Yeah.
Yes, everything he likes.
Right, 20 bungalow points if you drink some of that.
How many?
20.
25. 30.
40.
Shaking.
Keep drinking it. 50. Yeah. You keep going, we'll give you 100.
It looks solid.
Oh, it keeps going. Oh, he spat it back out. Well, I think we need to minus a few off that. We'll give you 30.
Minus.
He's off. Cheers, Brad. Thanks, mate. Thanks, Melvin. Welcome to the Bungalow. Who's next?
Do you know them? Do you know them? Ah! It's a nutcase. All right. Welcome to the Bungalow.
Yeah.
What have you got here, Vinegar? Is that your name?
Why's your name Vinegar?
Yeah.
Your name is really Vinegar?
Yeah.
Why is it Vinegar? Hang on, let's take off your coat. Is it really, really Vinegar?
Yeah.
So when you were christened, you said, we now call you... Oh, yes, for that. You are now called... Really, look at his eyes, he's an absolute nutbag. So anyway, right.
Vinegar, how old are you?
9.
Apparently you can do 40 sit-ups and run for 2 miles without stopping.
Yeah.
But you can't do it at the same time?
No.
Oh, okay.
Now, why is your nickname Vinegar?
Start getting strong.
Because Vinegar is strong.
Because Vinegar's strong.
Yeah.
Why is Vinegar strong?
I don't know.
Strong like you? Well, we're going to put you to the test now, Vinegar. Are you a stronger Vinegar? Are you? Are you Vinegar?
Well, we're going to find out.
Because look,
we've got some Vinegar! And now, we're going to give you a wrestling match with the bottle of Vinegar. Who's going to be the toughest, Vinegar or Vinegar?
Well, who's it?
Go!
Are you going to win?
All right, go!
Top off. Right, I think that's confirmed it. Vinegar is stronger than Vinegar. Thank you very much.
Conclusive proof.
Oh, by the way, what's in here? What's he brought us?
Oh, what did he bring us?
Why
did
he bring us loads of coal?
A present.
Why did
he bring
us coal?
Housewarming present.
Housewarming present. Thank you very much.
Here, Vinegar. Joe, you did knock over the bottle of Vinegar, didn't you? But yeah, because you think you're strong, yeah?
Yeah.
Go on then.
Kind of.
Rip that in half.
Oh, God.
We'll leave you with it.
We'll forget the next one will
It'll take a couple of hours, that. Who's next?
I beg your pardon.
Nickety-num-nums. What's nickety-num-nums when they're
out? Nickety-num-nums, everybody.
It's Freddy!
Freddy!
Yay! Welcome, Freddy. Welcome.
Ready for Freddy?
Welcome, Freddy.
What's that? You're here for the whole weekend, aren't you?
Yeah, oh, he's done it. Oh, he nearly did it.
Look what he's done.
Couple of bits.
He did. Look what he's done.
You are strong, Vinegar. Freddy, how old are you?
9.
You're very good at walking into walls.
Yeah.
Let's see you walk into a wall. Oh! But he's perfectly all right. Yes. That's a very good game. I like that one, Freddy.
Thank you.
Now, you were nicknamed Squeak when you were a baby because you squeaked when you were asleep. Did it sound like this? Are you squeaking?
No.
Is that you didn't squeak like that, right?
No. Do you believe in fairies?
Yes.
Because it says here, you hunt for good and bad fairies, and you keep them in jam jars in your room. Is that true?
Yeah.
Where do you find them?
I find them anywhere around the house, and there's different types of them.
Well, have
Freddy,
a look at what Dickie Doodah.
Hey, look what I've got here. I've got a jam jar. Guess what's in the jam jar?
A fairy.
Could be more than one. Shall I have a look?
Tip them out. Careful.
Let's open it up.
Careful.
Here they come.
That you do quite good and bad.
A fairy, good luck to you. I hope you win.
I don't. I hope you lose all your points and get gunned twice.
Annoying.
got them, the good and the bad.
Spoiled them, Freddy!
Sorry about that. We'll find another couple for you. In fact, why don't you go around looking for another couple and we'll introduce the next one.
Lots of fairies, fairy Freddy.
Yeah. Can't find any more fairies in here, that's for sure.
Morning, dear. How are you?
Fine.
What's your name?
Georgia.
It's Georgia, look who's here.
Georgia, the one who has madness behind her eyes.
Look what they've done to our phone book. Hey, how is the strong?
That's not. How are we supposed to find a nanny knob knob plumber now? Hey, how are we supposed to find a spanky flanker electrician? Oh man, look at them all. Go on, get that phone. Go throw it all around. Go make yourselves at home. Go on,
yeah. Everyone, come over here and meet Georgia. Georgia, how old are you?
I'm 8 years old.
Georgia is 8 years old.
Yeah.
And it says here that you love making people jump.
Yes.
But hate having it done to yourself.
Yes.
Right then. Why don't you try and make Dom jump?
Yeah, okay then.
You'll never make me jump, because I have nerves and steel. There's no way that you can make me jump.
Right. Is she going to make him jump?
Oh, yeah.
What? No, she's not.
She used a defibrillator! That made him jump. Look at the state of the bungalow!
Already! Mess.
Brilliant. Well, why don't you kidney pop around
it's
a bit as well.
It's very nice to have you here, and all of you lot too, because ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's the bungalow!
What's happening, guys? It's going to be a very interesting show. It's going to be a very interesting 2 hours. Now, bungalow heads, you are here to make a mess, trash our bungalow, have a great time over the weekend, to be 8 and 9 year olds, and also to get bungalow points, to get bungalow prizes. And the first prize is this. It's 16p.
16p.
Not 16p. Who wants to win 16p?
No.
What could you do with 16p? I don't know.
Second prize.
Second prize.
I'll throw it at you.
It's
what is it?
A games console. We're game.
Oh, it was a games console. We're game. Yay! And we got our first prize. Oof. As always, it's a rib tickler. Have a look at this. Now get off!
Widescreens, big TV, and DVD player.
No.
He's gonna jump again! He's gonna jump again! Oh!
Never mind.
anyone want that first prize? You won it, Georgia.
Oh, yeah,
if you're the winner of Saturday morning's bungalow, you get the most points at the end of Saturday, then you'll get this prize, this bonus prize.
Prizes.
Now the bungalow heads to come in, please.
There was just no need for that prize. Sorry, everyone.
Save your energy. You're here for
it. I think they got plenty.
You're here for the whole weekend. Okay. Oh, no, you can make me look like a... Oh.
Peed yourself.
Right, here, listen.
Just get off.
Bungalow heads, in this bucket, in this bowl, we've got songs,
it's
and you've
not
got
to. A bucket.
You've got. I know it's not a bucket; it's a bowl. you've got to sing the missing word out of the songs. We'll take one of them. There you are, and we'll go meet the prize idiot.
All right, bye.
See you in a bit.
Bye. Stay there. Prize idiot, help! They're a bag of nuts. Ooh. Anyway, how are you?
Oh, I'm okay.
Our next door neighbour. They're prize idiots.
Oh.
What's happened to your arm? What's happened to your arm?
I might do the wobbly cheek dance in a minute.
What's happened to your arm?
Well, I was taking a walk in the park the other day. And I saw a really lovely dog, and I asked the man, does your dog bite? And he said no. So I went to stroke it, and he bit me.
And what did he say?
Oh, I said to him, you said your dog doesn't bite.
And he said, that is not my dog.
Oh, how do you know?
Because we were there hiding up a tree.
Oh, sneaky.
Now, why don't you just go and do a wobbly cheek dance right into
your punchline.
Only Brad's good at that. He's actually good at that.
Ian, Tashbang Wallet. How many members of the public will have Dirty Norris smeared on their top lip? You can win that for a photo. You have to ring in and get 09901900500.
And what are these? What are these?
Oh, it's 2 tickets to Monty and his incredible exploding Icelandic sausages.
You got there in the end.
Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, yes.
2 tickets to whatever he said.
Oh,
there you go.
Would
you like, to me, they look like eyes floating in formaldehyde. There you go. So they are bungalow@bbc.co.uk. Email in now. We're going to try and get a record number of emails this week. We got 100,000 last week. We're going to get even more this week.
You can
be
Almighty Kid as well if you phone or email too.
Get in touch. We'd love to hear from you. We're really interrupted.
What else are you doing today? Anything nice? What are you
going
to the footy?
Oh, footy?
You going to the footy?
What's that?
Footy for football.
Well, he doesn't play footy, he plays flipper.
No, flipper ball.
Flipper ball.
Flipper ball.
All right, well, we'll play a game of flipper. Go away.
Ta-ra! Yeah. I don't want to... I don't want to go back.
We've got to go back to them.
I know,
now.
I don't want to go back.
It's going to be a nutty weekend.
Maybe if we do the energy walk over to them, then they might just calm down. Ready?
Maybe, probably not.
Oh, that'll come. Dad's watching on the back of the queue. Oh, yeah, that's it. You see, it works. See, it works. Gouger tape a bag of nuts.
Right. Here we go then. Vinegar, you're going first. Come over here.
Right, stop it.
Vinegar, pass us.
Can we just carry on with the show? It's like a crash in here.
Right, your song
line
is.
Line up, get off, woman.
Your song is Green Day, Vinegar. Let's hear you singing that missing word. Oh. Go! I want this empty street. When they hit the blank. On the boulevard
of broken. Toilets!
Broken toilets!
On the boulevard of broken toilets.
Give him five bungalow points for that.
Get off, woman!
Right, Matilda, what was your song?
Hey, Otis.
Otis.
Hey, Otis.
Something.
Otis, what?
Otis
what?
I don't know.
Where's your bit of paper?
Find a piece of paper!
Around here!
It's gonna be here somewhere.
He found it.
So we're just gonna.
Oh, you got it.
Oh, Oasis.
No, I'm not Otis.
Right. I'm
going to be the one that kills me.
No.
that was not necessarily that of the BBC.
Thank you, Matilda. Georgia, come on over here. Ooh. We'll give you 2 points for that, Matilda. Yep. Georgia, your song is.
We don't.
She's singing Carly Minogue. Carly Minogue's here. Go, Georgia. Everybody's doing a
brand new dance now. Come on, baby. Ice cream dance.
Ice cream.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Hey, wait, Georgia. What is the ice cream dance? Because we're bringing out some music.
You dress up as an ice cream and then you just do this.
Come on, ready?
Do you do this as well? Yeah.
Right,
coming over. It's your turn, mate. That was good, that, Georgia. We'll give you 10 bungalow points for that.
Yeah. His song is busted.
Yeah,
it's an asylum.
Freddie is busted!
Do it again.
Bungalow.
Yes, that's exactly what you've done this morning, but you haven't crashed it. You've trashed it. Right, Brad, come on.
Brad Bradley.
You are Jamelia. It's Jamelia. I don't know who you are, but you
must be some kind of alien.
Yeah!
Always
15 bungalow points plus 35 equals 50.
Right, Elliot, you haven't done yours yet. Brad, 50. Where's your bit of paper? You lost it. Can you remember who you were?
No.
It's the last song anyway, but he's lost his bit of paper. Whoever's left, you're the one. It's pink. You're pink.
Oh, another time.
Right, try again so we can hear you. Ready?
Toilet.
That's two toilets. Can we do repetitions?
Another toilet?
No. Do you want another go? Say a different word apart from toilet.
Okay.
Go on, get pink off my face, woman!
Monkey.
Monkey started, yeah. We'll get this monkey started. We're going to get this party started.
Now look at the bungalow. Look. Any points for Elliot?
Who's on the phone?
Me.
Who is it?
Gary.
No,
Gary.
I'm not.
Gary.
Right.
Where is Gary?
Here.
He's in Jamaica.
Does anyone want to go?
Distance call.
Does anyone want to go and rip the curtains off? Go on then.
Oh no.
Here's what's happening. I'm picking up the bungalow until 11 o'clock this morning.
Excellent.
It's going to be an absolute madhouse,
mate. It's like the good old days.
Can you stand it, viewers? Can
the baby race is back as well. That's like the good old days as well.
Ring all your mates and tell them the baby race is back.
Oh no, it's just like the good old days. No,
the good old days. Just like the good old.
That's not like the good old days, but it's still good anyway.
Oh. And not forgetting creamy muck muck. It's called Muck Watch today. It's worth staying with us.
It really is worth staying with us. Oh, no.
We need.
That's just perfect. If you ever saw a cherry on top of a cake, that's it. You've probably run around so much, you shut down the electricity. Which means that we've got to play the mucky pudding.
Yay! I didn't know what it's called.
They're sitting in the darkness cause we didn't pay the bills, but we'll generate some mortgage with the pedal pushing skills. Watch out for flying muckrack as you hop on puff on strain. But at least we'll have some light in the mucky puddle power shower game.
Yay! It's time for the mucky puddle power shower game. Now, we need to get some more electricity here in this here bungalow. So get on your bikes, bungalow. Get on your what?
Bicycle.
Yes, right. On your
bicycle.
Yes. Because we want to ride our bicycles, we want to ride our bikes, we want to ride our bicycles to get some power back in here. Now, the person who pedals the furthest in the time and gets the most amount of power will be the winner of,
I reckon a big score, 200!
Come on, we need electricity in here! And we want it now! Have you all got your goggles on?
Got your goggles on? Yes, they have.
Make some more mess, I know you like it. 1 minute on the clock, your time starts now! Oh, Should we hang on a minute.
Snowing Dustin! It's snowing Dustin!
Come on. Perfect, Dad.
They're riding their bikes to make the lights come back on in the bungalow. 200 points if you have ridden the furthest, bungalow head. Big finish.
15 seconds left.
They're riding their bicycle.
Right, that's it. Stop pedalling, whatever you do, and mind your fingers by the wheel.
See, that was quite a good... It's exercise as well as entertainment, right?
Exercise.
Okay, you pedalled 0000000. You didn't pedal anywhere, right? Zero all the way. Okay, let's have a look what you did. You got 0000. You didn't pedal anywhere either.
Okay, over here we've
got...
They're all booked. Not. 328.
328.
Did you have fun, Matilda?
Yes.
Get off.
You're in the lead at the moment,
did
Matilda.
Look, she had fun. A bungalow had having fun. Did you have fun?
Yeah, I'm disgusting.
You are, yes, you are disgusting. That's 269. Matilda's in the lead.
Still in the lead.
Let's go ahead to Freddy, let's have a look. Oh, nothing. Oh dear, the clock didn't work on that one either. So it was a new game, it was great, and it worked, and we're gonna give you all.
I think we should just give them all 200 bungalow points.
We're going to give them all 50 bungalow points. But Matilda, for getting the furthest, you're going to get 212.
Yes! 212! Yeah, the light's going to come back on now. You've pedalled that far, Matilda. Try the lever. Right. Pull the lever.
All right. Let's have a go. Decorum is what we need, because we're about to watch a cartoon.
Cartoon?
Alright then. Lift doors. Oh, you haven't got a videotape, do you?
Golden videotape.
Oh, lovely. Alright then. Right, well, you can just go take it. The lift doors go open. Right, you can watch Cramp Twins. Oh, watch my chops. Choice is yours.
See you in 10.
What? Oh. You want to see something? Do you? Do you? All right. Dang it! What do you think the extreme woman looks like?
Black hat, pointy nose with probably a pimple on the end of it, and a mouthful of rotten teeth.
Oh yeah, look at this. Dee dee dee
dee dee. Hello Dick and Dom, I'm Fergie. Now behave yourselves and play nicely or I'll throw a football boot at your head. And if that doesn't work, I'll throw a flip-flop at your belly. I'll throw sandals at your shoulders and I'll puff a plimsoll in your sock. So behave yourselves.
He's football crazy. He's football man.
Man United! United, Man United.
Turncoat.
Man United.
Turncoat.
Anyone watch the Man U game this
Turncoat.
Week?
Turncoat.
4-2. Comes from Sheffield.
Yeah,
Arsenal.
Right,
I've just bought
Sheffield
Man
again.
United. Sadly, what is thinking of a bungalow
Everyone
with
from Manchester supports Man City.
Shut up and some nutty bungalow heads.
Yeah.
We're all a bit mad this morning. A bit mad. Email.
And next week we'll have Ian Rush in the picture frame. All right.
Have an email. Have an email, dear. Geordie says, my mum said I could have two friends round for tea next week. Would you like to come? Would you like to go for tea?
Where?
Geordie's house?
Geordie?
Yeah. Geordie.
Why?
Tea and cakes.
Why not?
Jelly and ice cream.
What?
What do you got on the menu? Menu.
Oh, something we've got on the menu.
Would you like to throw them?
No, not prizes. Oh, you're
okay,
go for it.
You can just throw them towards Geordie.
Yes, yes, you can. I'll throw you in a minute. Now,
I'll throw you.
Oh, all right, fair enough. Okay, look, here we go. This one says, it's from Bob the...
What's that say?
Malevolent. Stickman demands that you give him back his vegetables, which he lent to you last week. He was going to make soup with them and is becoming rather hungry now. Also, blah, blah, blah.
Matilda, your turn.
Go on.
You win those two. Keep emailing bungalow at bbc.co.uk. Three left. Tashbang Wallop.
What do you think about these bungalow heads, for example, that you could email about that?
Tashbang Wallop is a new game on the bungalow. How many members of the public will have a step up to have a photo taken with Dirty Norris smeared on...
Crazy.
What? What did you say?
Please say we're crazy.
No,
we're crazy.
You're not crazy. You're just standing around. That's not crazy.
Yeah, it is.
No.
I'm calling Gary now.
Carry on.
Where was I? How many members of the public were several to have a photo taken with Dirty Norris smeared on their top lip as a cashbang? Wallop. Sorry, the phone's still ringing. Hello, is that Isabella?
Hello.
Isabella, is that you?
Oh,
you're looking nice today.
Thank you.
You look a bit like an apple.
You look like a prune.
A pom.
What do you reckon?
Get up!
These bungalow heads are a bit balmy, aren't they?
Yeah. She's
Freddie, would you like to talk to Isabella?
Hello.
Hey.
It's Freddie.
Yeah.
Is it Freddie? Are you ready for
Freddie? Freddie,
bye. Yeah, stop poking my bum with that finger! Get up!
Isabella, how many members of the public do you think are going to step up for a photo with Dirty Norris on their tash?
I think you'll get five.
Five tar.
Alex Fitzpatrick, how are you?
Hiya.
You're from Sondi?
Yeah.
Lovely, all right then. And how many tashes? How many tashes?
Four.
Potato head.
Thank you, potato spud. Bye.
Right then, bungalow heads.
How many did you say? Three.
Isabella's chosen five. He said four. Alex has chosen four. He's Alex with four. I'm Isabella with five. You have to choose your team. If you're right, you'll get 20 bungalow points. Choose your team now!
Oh no. Do you know what? Wait, hang on a minute. You were late. We're gonna have to choose our teams again. All right, you're a bad man. Right, Gable, get back to the sofa. Get back to the sofa and choose your teams again now.
That's what was supposed to happen.
Worth waiting for. All right, then, go on.
All right, then, let's see how many members of the bully will stand to have it.
Hello,
Norris stand! Here they are! There's me trying to find members of the public. No one seems to want to step up at the moment. Is Isabella going to be right with five or Alex with four? Here, we've got one. I've got one. There you are, bungalow heads. Look. She's having Dirty Norris smeared on her tash. There we are. She's got a Dirty Norris tash. And they look, oh, he might be doing it. There you are. There you are, another one. That's two.
He's going to do it. Look at him. Is he insane?
She's having a
mustache.
Dirty Norris tash. What?
Will they do it?
Who knows?
Who knows? Who does that? Him!
Yeah!
And that little kid!
He steps up for a bit.
Go on, get the kid!
Yeah, he's gonna have a Dirty Norris tash.
No.
Yeah, there you are, just asking.
So far, we're winning.
Is it gonna be five?
No, yes. No!
It's four at the moment. Will there be another one? Will there be one more? There's
no. No,
left.
Come on, we're gonna win so far.
Oh,
7 seconds left.
No!
Yeah.
No!
Yes.
Looks like, yes, she's taking it. It looks like Isabella is the winner! Here's the photo. Take the photo.
Can we have my
am I?
Lovely.
We are going to stick it in the family
album. Right, we'll stick it up on
stick
the
it up. There you go. So who won that? Vinegar, Freddie and Brad are the winner of 25 Bungalow points each.
And Isabella, you said five, Isabella. So you get that prize.
Five. There we go. And,
all right, Isabella.
25. Isabella.
Isabella.
Hello.
You win that.
Yay.
Oh, wow. What is it?
I
don't know. Radio or something.
All right, then. Alex.
No.
Alex, listen, mate. I'm really sorry. All the bungalow heads are going to join you in singing what you get. Bungalow heads, come over here. You know the Diddly Squid song. Oh, come on. We're going to sing it. Ready?
Diddly Squid. Diddly Squid.
You get Diddly Squid. There you go. Do you want to throw that? There you go. Wait.
Oh. I didn't mean that.
Oh, my eye.
Hold on. I've got the feeling again.
What do you mean that feeling again?
That feeling where I feel that something arrived. Something's arrived at the door.
Oh, look, doorbell, how strange.
No.
What?
Bungalow heads.
What? Look!
It's a giant ice cream!
Yeah! Oh, lovely. I do like the alpine peace. The mountain set against the crystal blue sky and the white snow. Yeah. Perfect conditions for snowboarding!
Oh, yeah, dude, hang ten!
Yeah. It's so good. It makes me want to... Lovey, you can't do that round here. It's dangerous. You might cause an avalanche.
You don't be silly!
Are they my trainers?
And now, on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow.
Stretchy pitch.
The cat's back again.
Dick, right. Oh, hang on. Wait a minute. Here.
Go, bend down, Freddy. And I want you to turn this up the flat and say to him, Lucasen, can I hear? Say, pussycat.
Where have you been?
No, just say pussycat.
Pussycat.
Where have you been?
I've been to Broadway.
Ask him what happens there.
What happened there?
Well, I'll show you. It's in Letchworth Garden City. Hello. Today I've come to Letchworth Garden City. Is it a garden? Is it a city? Is it a dump? Or is it quite pretty? Dunno. Let's have a look. True to its name, Letchworth Garden City is a garden in a city. Just look at this view. It's truly spectacular. Letchworth has got bins, people, houses and cars. And over there, two chimneys spewing toxic fumes into the environment. Ooh. Ooh, why not take a decoration tip from the good folk of Letchworth? If you've got any old fencing or gates that you've robbed from a football ground or something, then why not screw them to the side of your house and put some plastic flowers in them? I think you'll agree, they look beautiful. Letchworth is also known for its abundance of factories. I've come to this one, what makes bits for cars. I'd rather have gone to a cat food factory, but they said I weren't allowed in case I went poops. Let's go inside. I wonder what this button does. Oh. Knickers. Thanks, guys. See you around. In Letchworth, they're trying out a new scheme where they've replaced glass windows with wooden ones. And I think you'll agree, the effect is spectacular. Letchworth has got some very funny shop names. For example, Andrew Merry, MSC, FCO, P-Tom. And this one's called 21CH. I think he were in Star Wars Phantom Menace. Ooh, there's even a place in Letchworth called The Wind. I'm so excited, viewers, because people think that Broadway is in New York. Girlfriend, it's right here, right? In Letchworth Garden City. Broadway! I'm going to see if I can find any plays. Oh, great. On Broadway.
Sadly, there were no productions open on Broadway, but I did see an old man with a carrier bag stuck to his foot. So, to conclude, red fact, I didn't find out what a lech was worth, but I think it's about $3.95. Blue fact, for legal reasons, I have to retract my earlier statement about toxic waste spewing from them two chimneys. It is, in fact, fresh air. Yellow fact, for legal reasons, I must point out that 21CH is not a character in Star Wars The Phantom Menace. If he had have been, he would have been crud like Jar Jar Binks. Oh, for legal reasons, I must retract yellow fact.
Ah, now at the end of a busy day, I like to relax by watching Girls Aloud videos. But a close second is a nice bit of fish and chips from a quality chippy. So I'm going to tuck in... cack. Tweety! Wasn't that fun, Dom?
Oh, it was.
Okay.
It looked lots of fun.
It was fun, I suppose. You better get it over with.
Don't smack him. Well, actually, go on then, smack him.
My eyes!
And again. Come on.
Right, lads, come out, play clean, flat pack at the back, stop and have a snack, then when we're on the rack, we'll run off to the shack, I'll give you some flack, and then I'll throw another boot at your head!
He's football crazy, he's football mad!
Don't tell him to shut up, he'll throw a boot at your head!
Oh, hey, someone at the door, tell you what, hide,
who could it be?
Hide, just hide!
Why didn't phone it? They're phoning it. That's why I can hear you talking.
Say the line, kid. Hello?
Hello.
Say the line, you're on telly. Bye.
Hi.
No, wait! Has anyone got a hanky?
No.
Where was that?
this way, over there. Over there. No, not me.
I think.
Here, come here.
I think.
Stop! Thank you very much for helping us with that game. You were spectacular.
She actually was spectacular. Got all your lines spot on.
Congratulations, you scored 2 points, which means you win a snotty hanky. Enjoy your prize, and remember, it's time to move on, because the rest of your life starts right now.
And this is what's happening for the rest of the morning. I'm Dick and Dom in the bungalow. It's 11 on BBC One, with all of this. A world record attempt in a bit. Sue's back.
Something to do with onions. There we go. We've also got Looney Tunes. Yeah, you wanted it back instead of Batfink, so we're giving it you back on a Saturday.
We've got Batfink.
Yeah, but just for Sunday.
Ugly Mug Off. That's a new game.
Very good. And Eenie Meenie Macaraco Rare-Eyed Dominaka. We've also got the Baby Race as well.
Creamy Mug Mug. It's Muck Watch this week, all that and more.
There you go.
You what? What was it?
This morning. I'm going to get Baby Race back, and I've got a funny feeling the band might be back. I don't know. There might be.
It's not until later.
Let's see if they calm down. We ask them if they want to watch cartoons. I'm going to head. Do you want to watch a cartoon?
Yeah!
Well, will you calm down if we watch a cartoon?
No!
No, great. All right, then.
That's BB3B, nice. Anyone?
Ow!
Yeah, BB3B!
You don't
BB3B! BB3B! BB3B!
BB3B! See you in a shirt while.
Oh, we're not with the Hendersons.
Matilda!
Right, my nickname's the hairdryer because I can make this noise. Ooh. I can also do curling tongs, hair straightener, heated rollers, and Billy Connolly.
Hello there! My name's Billy Connolly! Don't you think that's a good impression, Gregory?
We're football crazy, it's football night!
Big Alex! If you just tuned in, you probably heard him already. Yes, we've got some very loud, mad bungalow heads with us this morning.
Hello, bungalow heads!
Oh, they love it.
Are you fixing the television, Matilda?
Bye-bye.
No. Oh, I am.
Top your emails. Cameron Woodcock says, I've tried screaming at my mum to stop her from taking me swimming so that I don't miss the show this morning, but it hasn't worked. If you send me some eyeballs, I'll put them in her drink and make her sick. Okay, you can do that. No more swimming next week. Ta.
Cheryl. Is that Roche?
Roche?
Cheryl.
Roche.
Hello. Yes. I was at my friend's, Jade's, and she have her chicken nuggets, chips and baked bean in her hand, and I went to kick her, and she threw it in the air, and the chicken nuggets and chips went on the floor, but the baked beans on the down the skin.
Don't kick your friends!
Oh, hey! Oh!
Throw it at
Dick, what?
Throw the thing at Dick, because he kicked you.
The paper at Dick.
Yeah, kill him!
Kill him!
Can't kill me! There'll be no more show!
Hey, well, it will be.
It'll be mine! Time for emails. More eyeballs. Get off. One left, bungalow@bbc.co.uk. The baby race is back!
Woo! Yeah!
Baby race! We got the cutest little baby race! Who'll be the winner of this happy, sloppy, nappy chase? You'll see them crawl on their tongue, they got a rash on their bum. It's the Bungalow Baby Race!
Here on the Baby Racing, and this week's Baby Race, Vicky and Tom with Baby Daisy.
Daisy here, out of the same stable as Cheeky Boy and Laughing Coppers. Something to prove today, a face happy, a full nappy. She got a mama, she got a pappy.
They're all baby pirates this morning. And secondly, Annette and Nick with Baby Sam.
Yes, here's Sam, withdrawn at Wolverhampton for bashing other babies with biscuits and going whittles. He's happy, he's a baby, and that's nice, baby.
Smile at them, Dom, that's it. Next, we've got Harry and Marion with Baby Sophie.
Ah! Yes, here's Sophie. Disappointing effort at Fontwell when she lost interest and screamed for the thimbles. The thimbles, of course, weren't there. They were busy brushing their big roly-poly stripe-ridden bodies.
Debbie and Des with Baby Aaron.
Yes, Aaron here clearly sets the standard. He'll dribble, wobble and fluff a lot. A showy racer in his melon head should keep him involved at the finish.
Curly Head, Rashenda and Ben with Baby Sebastian.
Here's Sebastian. He's moon-faced, sulky, doesn't like it damp under his knees, has worn cotton wool knee pads in the past. Today, though, he has nudie knees.
They know wool on him, Mama.
Lisa and Yvonne with Baby Lily, finally.
Lily, too, a strong contender, raced and won against Harry Redknapp's chipstick rucksack of Goodwood and pockets of fluff in the Sunshine Goofy Yahoo Stakes at Lingfield.
But which baby is going to win the baby race? Yes, the baby's going to start the start line. They have to leg it to the other end of the racetrack. It's as simple as that. Bungleheads, you've got to back your baby now. Go and back the baby. You think he's going to win the baby race this morning. Once you've stuck your sticker on, come and stand around here. Come and stand around here so there's no cheating. No cheating, please. Come on around. Baby.
Come on, make it be mine. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop. Right, Bungleheads, over here. See, you can't change your minds.
Right, babies, are you ready to race?
We're ready.
Oh, yes, right. Get into the start line.
Going to get ready.
Get into your positions.
Right, don't touch the babies, Bungalow. Don't get overexcited.
They are babies.
They are babies. Remember, they're mini humans.
The baby race is back on the bungalow, and the race starts. Now! You can see so far, baby Sam is actually in the lead of the pyro howl there. Baby Sam is legging it at the moment. A little bit of a push there. Baby Aaron is decided not to. Baby Sophie's actually starting to move. Baby Sophie is coming up now. Look at Baby Sam's coming up. But there goes Baby Aaron. Baby Aaron is actually going for it. Baby Aaron's gone the wrong way. He's changed parents. Baby Aaron's changed parent. Baby Sophie's in the back there. But is Baby Aaron going to win it? He's got one more step.
Oh, no, he's
turned around. He's turned around. All he needs to do is go over the line. Is he going to go over the line? There goes Baby Aaron. Is he going to get over the line? Oh, look, here comes Baby Sam. Yeah! Change parents. This is yours down here, Baby Aaron. Get him in. Oh, there goes Baby. Yes. Anyway, Baby Aaron, you win. You're the winner. We're going to see it on the board now to see which bungalow heads backed. Excuse me, boys. Let's have a look who backed Baby Aaron. And Baby Aaron was backed by Vinegar. Vinegar will give you 100 bungalow points.
Fancy watching a bit of Eenie Meenie?
We're not worrying you, are we?
Yeah,
he wants to watch it! He wants to watch it! We can't wait to watch it! Great! Eenie Meenie Macca Racca Rare, I don't like a chicken pop and dicky pop a pom pom.
It's time for Eenie
Meenie
Macca
Racca
Rare
Dominant
Chicky
Popper
Dicky
Whopper
on pom stick. We're in Aylesbury today to stick stickers of various sizes onto unsuspecting members of the public's backs.
Yeah, we start off small and then get larger and larger and larger until one of us two chumps gets caught and then we automatically lose.
So without further ado, let's go and
stick it.
Shut up.
Stick it.
Do you want a hand?
So, Aylesbury.
Push it a bit. There you are.
You join us for a new door.
Back in that, doesn't it?
And a new lay.
Push in the bin.
The court opens his account confidently. Wood to make his first deposit. And that's a good one. Unless my eyes deceive me, that's a slip on and a nip off. I've not seen that since the days of Peter Smacks, the great Albanian layer.
The dirty workman.
Hey?
Dirty workman.
Oh, did somebody say bogies?
Hello,
yes, they did, but this is my commentary box, so sling your hook.
There he goes.
You watch it? Who watches it?
I'll watch it,
there. When did you watch it?
McCourt.
You're doing bogeys last week? Where did you play it?
In a bogey conversation.
Nice one. Excellent stuff. Go on then.
That other great international sport he plays, of course. I think that was the lay there. We're not quite sure yet.
Nice one.
Waiting for confirmation.
Bogey! Yes! Wrong game!
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, you've been had, mate.
Has he been had? Has he, McCourt? Yes, he has. It's a lovely number three. Well, that was so quick. Such a sleight of hand from Wood. We didn't even see the lay.
Oh, I'm going to have to come here and get a chip butty later.
Yeah, smell good, them chips.
Lay on lay from McCourt.
Yeah, look at that.
Stuff.
Look at that,
eh?
Nice chips.
Wood to spawn. He's going for. Is he going for the triple? That's a triple. A lay on lay on lay.
Oh, what
a beautiful.
Cheers, mate. Hello, sir. Can I have a word with you before you go in?
Yeah,
why not? Flat caps.
flat cap.
Oh. How long have you been wearing your flat cap? A nice one, that, isn't it?
Look at that from a court. That's an absolute badger of a lay.
Barber. Very nice.
And he hasn't
put
noticed.
Put it back on so they can have a look at it.
He hasn't noticed. That is phenomenal.
That's a nice one, isn't it?
Thank you very much.
That is just wonderful stuff from a court. Brazen, brave, courageous.
This filming is for a programme called Dick and Dom in Da Bungalow. Have you ever seen it?
Yes.
Who's this?
There's a nice, gentle lay from Wood.
Kaylee.
And a little Kaylee.
Hello. All right. Let's have a look at it.
Kaylee.
I suppose you could say that he'll be a nappy man with that.
Hello.
Hello. It's
lovely for you to face me.
All right.
Right. In goes McCord. Oh, well, he's played a couple of these bunker shots in the last few weeks. But he seems to be getting away with them.
That's beautiful.
That is beautiful.
Okay. Shall I roll my sleeves up? Okay. Nothing in my hands. Shall I catch those in? Which hand?
Wood with some diversionary work here.
Come on, one last guess.
Is it that one?
No.
Apparently he's supposed to be quite good with magic.
No. Hey? No, it's not.
But what he needs to be quite good with here is a size 10 sticker.
No?
These two players really pushing the boundaries of this match. It's a bit of a fumble from Wood. He's not even got the lay lined up.
Put it out of your flesh and...
Well, he's pulled off the magic trick.
In your back.
Magic.
And has he pulled off the size 10? McCord straight back in there with an 11. Phenomenal stuff.
Can we ask you a question?
Whereabouts are you from?
Wood. Gets good adhesion.
Japan!
Japan! Brilliant!
Japan, land of the rising sun, and now land of the big dick sticker. Look at that, it's a 13.
Whereabouts?
And Wood's going straight back with a 14.
Whereabouts in Japan?
Surely he's got to notice that.
Suzuka.
Suzuka.
Suzuka. Near Mount Fuji. You know Mount Fuji.
Oh, yeah, we're really getting run over.
So far, so good. Much merriment among these gentlemen of the Far East. But there's the rumbling. And it's a rumbling for Wood.
You've been had, mate.
McCord finally comes back with something in this competition.
He lost. Bye bye.
It was so close. Just as they were about to get on the bus.
First one. The first one.
Well done.
Thank you, Japanese men.
Thank you very much.
Get off!
And with a kiss, could this be the big comeback McCord is looking for? Leaving the scores now at Wood 5, McCord 1.
Genius! Yes! Is that your first one that you've won so
Finally,
far?
Finally, I'm winning one.
You are a bogey champ and I'm a neeny meeny champ.
Not yet.
You've seen it before when you're at home. How can we saw at home? Shut up. Anyway, look, let's have a look at the scores. Scores! We've got lots of scores. Here we go. And here they are. Dick and Dom in Da Bungalow. We've got in Rallyan. We've got 50 Bungalow points. Matilda with 262. And Brad with 155.
Vinegar, 180. Freddy, 75. And Georgia, 80. In the lead at the moment, Matilda with 262. One Matilda.
She's like an ever chimpanzee the way she dances around.
Well, a quick level of the prize. Third prize. 16p. If you want to win 16p, that's it.
Second prize, game console with game.
Game console with game.
Oh, and
big TV. First prize,
is this.
Big TV and DVD. And you'll get the bonus prize, and you're in the lead today. Bungle ahead, you'll get that bonus prize.
Ooh, yeah.
And I'm about to get that.
You're about to get what? Well, you are at the moment.
I'm winning.
You are at the moment. You don't know what might happen tomorrow.
We showed you the prizes. We showed you the scores.
And here we are in the bungalow, observing the bungalow heads in their natural habitat. Milling about, chattering about nonsense. But now, please follow me as we go to look at a truly, truly remarkable creature.
What happens to an illegally parked frog?
I don't know.
It gets towed!
That is possibly one of the worst jokes I've heard in my entire life.
Just seen a guy walk into the car.
What's that noise?
I just
heard
a noise.
Just
ring.
It's
is he alright in there?
He's coming from the toilet.
Morning!
Raymond Van Farmer here with a quick recap of BB3B. Now, having been consumed by a giant frig roll, our three little friends... Our three little friends need to find some welding equipment rather quickly. And now I'm going to finish off my self-portrait, after which I shall be displaying all of my work in a bus stop in Clifton in Nottingham, featuring the Mona Pig, the Laughing Cow, and a rather nice watercolour of a naughty little squirrel smelling something rather nice.
That's you!
That's a dolphin, not a squirrel.
A squirrel?
Frig rock. See you in a minute!
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We've got some work to do now. Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We need some help from you now. Come on, Scooby-Doo, I see you. Pretending you got a sliver. You're not fooling me, cause I can't see the way you shake and shiver.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? You got some work to do now. Come and tell me who I am.
At the end of a good clean contest, may the ugliest kid have won. It's the WBC Ugly Mug-Off, second half, round one.
Ugly Mug-Off, it's a new game on Dick and Dom. I understand. A new game on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. Here we've got a boxing ring. Going in the boxing ring is Freddie and Elliot. Come on, Freddie and Elliot, get inside. What? And here's Dom King. Put your gloves on, win again.
Okay, here we go. Now what I want is I want an Eddie and a Freddiot.
No, not an Eddie and a Freddiot.
Freddy and an Elliot. Because you guys have got 2 20-second rounds to try and pull as many faces as you possibly can.
The one who pulls the most amount of ugly faces in this time will be the proud owner of
200 bungalow points.
There you go. Oh yeah, the judges will be watching Elliot and Freddie. Three judges here, they'll be scoring you on the round. So, Freddie, Elliot, no touching. Come in. No touching. No rabbit game. And everything has got to be below the neck. Yeah, all right. Get to your corners, get to your corners. You're just pulling ugly faces at each other.
Don't
someone
smack
ring the bell when I say seconds
head.
Out, round one. Seconds out, round one!
Well, here we go, Brian. I've been looking to this this face pull-off all week, and Freddie's out with a good one there.
Yeah, the boy Elliot's doing well here. He ain't done no big faces yet, but he's got a face like duck cotton on a wet Tuesday morning when he wants to get going. Here's a nice one there, tongue out, straight in.
Oh, that was very nice from Freddie. I dare say
two,
that's a touch of the puzzle.
One.
Round
one, round one, round one, back, ding, 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 someone ding it, ding it, ding, 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 ding. Dom's supposed to be at the bell. Never mind. Right then, let's have a look what the judges are giving you for round one. This is for Elliot. Six. And six. It's 12. Six for both of you. It's level pegging.
Here's a replay.
Okay. Here's a replay.
Okay. Well, as you can see, there's some excellent face pulling there. He's really got into that. He really looks like he's been sucking a lemon.
He's a champion. He really is a champion. No denying that.
Get in your corners. Get in your corners. No touching, no rubber gunning. Everything below the neck. Seconds up. Round two.
Well, it's very tight, Barry, and I think we're going to have to see some very big faces from these two young men now.
Oh, there's a pull of the eye there off your boy. My boy's got a pull of the eyes, retaliated.
Well, I don't know. That's very good from Freddie. Use the eyelids, use of the droopy eyes and the tongue all in one. That's a nice flowing movement.
That's right. There's Elliot there with what we call the Anne Robinson.
And all look at that. That's
two,
shaky, Edward.
Let's have a look at the replay of round two. This is some of the action that happened.
I'd be very surprised if Freddie doesn't come out on top of this. Look at that shaky headwork there. Absolutely marvellous.
Right, it was six apiece in round one. What is round two going to give us? Elliot's got 11. Freddie's got... So Elliot, you're the winner!
Yeah! Yeah.
200 points, my friend! You are the Ugly Mug Champion! 200 bungalow points, sir.
Right. Well done, Elliot. 200 bungalow points for you. And now, should we go up there?
Yes, why not?
All right, the right bungalow, let's come on. We're going back upstairs now! Into the next room. Thank you very much.
Have you just trumped?
Beg your pardon?
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Right, let's have a good bungalow. Heads, bungalow scores. Here, take it over the bungalow. Here they are! This is what they look like at the moment.
250 for Elliot now after that game.
262 for Matilda!
And Brad, 155.
And Bitter Girl's got 180.
And Freddie's losing with 75.
And Georgia has got 80 BPs. That's bungalow points, not blue Peters.
You're still in the lead, Matilda!
Yeah!
But Freddie, come on over here.
Are you ready for Freddie? One, two, Freddie's coming for you. Three, four, you better lock the... Oh.
Freddie, do you know what this means?
I'm doing the pants stand.
You certainly are. Do it.
Oh, get I got
it! Come on, Bungalow Heads.
Where's the bungalow heads? Where's the bungalow heads? Where's the
bungalow heads?
Where's the bungalow
heads? Oh, they were.
Yeah, yeah, baby, look at Freddie. I dance in your pants!
You dance in your pants, Freddie? Now, are you going to get more bungalow points? Are you going to get more bungalow points? Stop whipping me with your pants.
Ow. Beautifully, beautifully done.
Ow.
You want to go?
Right, here are some pictures of me reading it with my pants on my head. What? Oh, hello, I'm only 6 months old, but I find your hijinks extremely amusing.
Hijinks?
The article in the Guardian paper was great. And there he is reading it.
Ah, oh, couldn't agree with him more.
Ta.
Okay, next one, here we are. Hi, Dick and Dom again. Josh and Mad Mum here, sending you pictures of us doing the pants dance in Dad's new Christmas boxes. Please, can you come on the show? Can we come on the show? Please, we probably not know.
Who was it from?
Last one. Did I not say?
Joshua, yeah.
Yeah,
Joshua.
All right, right.
Here we go.
Hi, Dick and Dom. Well done on winning an award. That was ages ago. That was ages ago. But it does stand for, BAFTA stands for Big and Fat Twits Award.
Yes,
or Brilliant, Artistic, Fantastic, Talented Adults. Yeah. Mama says, All right, blah, blah, blah. Holly Frost, thank you very much. Thank you.
You all win big pants. Who's got the big pants? Show them the big pants. Where are the big pants? Show them
the big pants. Where are the big pants?
No.
They're gone.
Do you want
They're
to
gone.
Send in a picture? You can. We just like there. Bungalow@bbc.co.uk is the email address. Or this is the other address. It's Dick and Dom to Bungalow, PO Box 3894, London W12 6XX.
Snail mail. But yeah, you can email in pictures as JPEGs because we're technical like that. Look, and you win these great big stinky puppy pants.
Faggy.
One. Wunderbar. Wunderbar.
Oh.
Lovey, it's very kind of you offer, but are you sure this hypnotism is going to work? Oh, yes, yes. Look into my eyes.
Oh.
No, around my eyes, into my eyes.
Ooh.
And now, You're under!
Pause! If you've just joined the bungalow, here's a quick reminder of who everybody is. This is Diddy Dom. That's not his real nose. His real nose once belonged to black and white comedy star Charlie Chipan. So it's in a museum in America. You can make your own Diddy Dom at home by stacking 3 tins of beans and pelting them with melon balls. This is Diddy Dick. He's nice. He likes to go skipping around the garden, but has recently been attacked by some robo-badgers. They're malicious little beasts. If you see one, kick it and place a haddock in its workings. This is a small crystal featured in today's Diddy Dick and Dom sketch. It hasn't done anything funny or whatever, like yeah, like duh. It's just a piece of glass. And as for the rest of them, who knows what they'll get up to as we continue to watch this morning's edition of Dick and Dom in the Bungalow!
He's gonna put me off now. What are we gonna do? I know, just smile and wave. It's running down my leg. Hey, it's in my sock.
Dick and Dom's death-defying, crazy, mad and horrifying. Attempted record qualifying, tension is electrifying.
We sue from Guinness verifying, there's no chance of falsifying.
The BBC proudly present a bungalow world record attempt.
Hey, and Sue, my understanding is back off holiday.
Hey, wait, come back, bungalow, let's come down. Sue,
have a good holiday.
Lovely holiday.
If you don't watch your way, we broke a world record.
I know, it always happens when I'm not
you're
there.
You're jinxed, Sue. It's all your fault.
Now, okay.
I remember this one. I've tried this one before, haven't I?
You have.
I failed.
Yes.
So what is it again?
It's the fastest time to eat a raw onion.
Right.
It's quite simple.
So since I did it last time, I failed, mate.
No, I'm allergic to raw onions. I'll keel over. And do you want to keel over on telly? Shut up. Sorry, that's all right.
I can't do it. I've already tried it and failed.
I know you've been practicing. Can we do it one each? Can we have one each?
You can do one each. That's absolutely fine.
There you go, mate. Come on. Okay, what's the current world record for eating one of these honking great stinking balls of matter?
1:32. You can drink as much water as you want to in the meantime.
Come on, get your onion as well.
Here we go with this foolish nonsense. You're gonna end up looking silly again.
Here, I'm saying to the missus now, don't expect a kiss later. All right.
All right. You ready, guys?
Do you think we can do it?
Yeah!
Smell that! Smell it!
Smell it!
Get your eyes going, isn't it? All right, then.
Okay.
3, 2, 1,
go.
Yummy! He's not eating it!
No, it's coming!
He's not eating it in your face!
I ate it last time and I...
Come on!
Barfed everywhere! I'm not barfing again!
In your belly!
I barfed last time! Oh, he is now! Look at that! That's what happens if you eat a raw onion. No, don't put water on him. He's trying to attempt a world record. He's attempting a world
record. Okay.
I just threw up.
Oh, okay. Stop. I'll get you back.
Stop!
Do you think it was successful? That was a really good attempt, but not successful, I'm afraid.
You see, I think that's the first time anyone's ever puked live on television.
You should be really proud of that.
Did you see it?
Yeah, that was really nice.
No, I actually did. You must have been on a different shot at the time. I've just washed it all off. You come back and look at it. Everywhere.
That could be a record.
Sorry, do you want a kiss?
No, thanks.
For sure.
Yeah.
Right. Here, look who's here to sort things out. Harry
right,
Bass.
You lot, be here. Pack it in. Now, I've just made a discovery here.
What's that?
Harry Bat, Bat Fink.
Yeah.
Bat Fink, Harry Bat.
Yeah.
Harry Bat, Bat Fink. We must be related, war kid.
I would love to. Yeah, on now.
Right, great. I'm going to call Dada.
All right.
Well, that one went well, didn't it? See you in a bit.
Oh, you lot are little monkeys. We're live. We're in London.
and our operators are standing by to take your call. Good morning and welcome to Mugwatch UK. This is your chance to help us catch some of the country's muckiest criminals. We begin this evening with a horrendous crime featuring a man, a blue car, and a monkey.
On Thursday, the 3rd of February, Miles Jiggins was minding his own business. On his way to work, he was passed by a blue car. The monkey then ran out in front of him and off up the street. He was then spattered by a ladle of creamy muck-muck. As you can see from the reconstruction, it was a particularly creamy crime.
If you have any information on this, then please call our operators who are waiting to take your call. And of course, all calls are in strictest confidence. Joining me now is Superintendent Dominic Wood from the Buxton Division, who's going to tell us a little bit more about this crime. Superintendent, what can you tell us about this crime?
Well, a man just simply got a bucket of muck over his head and a bit like this. A bit similar to that.
Well, that's interesting because we didn't know that much already. Is there anything else that you could tell us about this crime?
Yes, there was also a blue car and a monkey. A monkey and a bucket of muck a bit like this.
Superintendent Buxton, thank you very much indeed.
Quite all right.
Fiona, it's over to you.
Thank you, Nick. This is the lost property part of the show where we return stolen goods to you at home. With me is Chief Inspector O'Doom. Chief Inspector, what is in this Aladdin's Cave of Treasures this week? Any exciting thing found?
We've got what looks like a carriage clock in there.
Does it ring any bells?
Not anymore.
What else have you got? All these treasures. What else have you found there to return to you at home? What else have you got?
We've got a few bits of... I mean, obviously, if you recognise any of these goods... Yes. That's a hat in there.
Please do get in touch. Our callers are there.
Oh, you look lovely, Fiona.
There's a lovely hat. If this is your hat, then please call in on our usual number. The phones are going wild at the moment. I think these could maybe your trousers. We've got a lovely sweater here. If this is your sweater, then get into the fashion and call in on our number, and it could be yours. Yes, there we are. So if you recognise any of these, please do give us a call. It's back to you, Nick.
Thank you, Fiona. Now, we did ask you to look at these faces from our last programme. Now, first was Artie Bart Truck. Now, he was involved in the Great Jelly Robbery, if you remember, also with Phil Collins. Police are still tracking him down to talk about his latest album. But he was sentenced to 2 buckets.
There was also Porridge Ham Fan. Porridge Ham Fan. He continually called other people Shirley. Shirley not, I hear you say. But thanks to your calls, he now calls them Rebecca. And he got 4 buckets of muck and 1 suspended. Porridge Ham Fan.
I wonder if you remember this man, Roger Fanananana, a consistent offender who took Dirty Norris as an occupational hazard. Well, again, thanks to your help, he got 2 consecutive buckets of muck and a damp plan in the face. Yes. Well, that just about wraps it up for today's show. Thanks for all your help. But before we go, we wonder if you could help us with one last terrible crime. It's one of the worst things we've ever covered here on Muck Watch. Police are very interested in apprehending a bunch of criminals who seem to be breaking into bungalows round about 10 to 11 on a Saturday morning. If you know anything, then please get in touch, Fiona.
Yeah, give us a call on our usual number, which is 0208 592 968 924 321. And if you see them, yes, as Nick said, please do give us a call.
So that number, just once again, is 0207 831 1234. Go, 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 go!
Stop!
We could have been anything that we wanted.
Get to it!
You're not!
Almighty King!
Dad, what's your name?
Molly!
Right, and who are you giving points to?
And who are you giving points to?
Matilda!
Come here, look. Say thank you.
Thank you!
How many points are you giving her?
50!
Is that brilliant? Why?
Because she's very forward.
Oh, there you go. 50 bungalow points for Cheers Almighty King, 50 bungalow points Matilda. Lovely stuff, yes!
Alright, let's be finding out who's in what position here on the Kingdom of the Bungalow for today.
The beginning of the end of the show!
We're here tomorrow on the CBBC Digital Channel, 9 o'clock till 11, yes?
Let's find out who this is going to be. Elliot, line up, Bungleheads, come forward if you're not there, we want to see you. Is it going to be Elliot or Matilda, Brad? Come on forward, Bungleheads. Elliot, Matilda, Brad, Vinegar, Freddie or Georgia. Georgia, Freddie, Vinegar, Brad or Matilda, we're ready. Elliot, the loser and the person that's going to get gunged is Freddie.
Freddie. Sorry, mate, you've got to go to the toilet to get a darn good gunging. Off you go.
And the winner of Saturday's Dick and Dom In Da Bungalow just on Saturday morning is Matilda.
Yeah!
You got the game, boy, yes!
Well done, Matthew,
Lovely.
I've already got a game, boy.
Join us, all of this, tomorrow.
That's the kind of stuff you can see tomorrow on the CBBC Channel 9
till 11.
Please do.
9 till 11, yeah, there we are. Bungalow, have you enjoyed yourself? Yes?
Yeah!
Oh, yeah, you can play the interactive game. Just press your red button and you can play Buttons, Bulls and Bungalow. Win some prizes on Ace. Free to play.
Should we shut up and see if Freddy's ready for a darn good
gunning?
Freddy, are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! He looks really happy, doesn't he? He looks really happy. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye.
And don't forget, Top of the Pops Saturday next to Norman.
Oh, yeah.
Come here.
Come forward.
Go, go, Dick and Dom. Go, go, Dick and Dom.